Hello, Vital Sign. Today we're going to talk about the strong product of graphs, also known as the graph strong product. If you haven't already, I suggest you check out my previous videos on the graph cartesian and tensor products, as that background will help you better understand the strong product. The strong product of graphs is a graph operation that takes two graphs as its input and outputs a new graph. In other words, the strong product of two graphs G and H is itself a graph, and it has vertex set equal to the Cartesian product of the vertex sets of graphs G and H. Each vertex in the strong product of two graphs G and H corresponds to a pair of vertices, where the left entry in the pair is a vertex in graph G, and the right entry in the pair is a vertex in graph H. There are three conditions for adjacency in a strong product graph. The first condition is this. Two vertices in the strong product of G and H are connected if their left entries are the same vertex in graph G and their right entries are adjacent vertices in graph H. The second adjacency condition states that two vertices in the strong product graph are connected if their right entries are the same vertex in graph H and if their left entries are adjacent vertices in graph G. Finally, the third adjacency condition states that two vertices in the strong product graph are adjacent if their left entries are adjacent in graph G and if their right entries are adjacent in graph H. In other words, if two vertices in the strong product meet any of the conditions that would qualify them for adjacency in a Cartesian or tensor product of those graphs, then they are connected. Let's work through a few strong products together. First, what is the strong product of two path graphs with two vertices? Well, we'll need the vertex set to begin with. Here it is. Next, we need to connect the vertices. Let's go one vertex at a time. According to the first adjacency condition, vertex A1 will connect to vertex A2, as the left entry of those vertices is the same vertex in graph G, that is, vertex A in graph G, and the right entries of those vertices are adjacent vertices in graph H. That is, vertex 1 is adjacent to vertex 2 in graph H. According to the second adjacency condition, vertex A1 will connect to vertex B1. As the right entry of those vertices is the same vertex in graph H, that is, vertex 1, and the left entries of those vertices are adjacent in graph G, that is, vertex A and vertex B are adjacent. Finally, according to the third adjacency condition, vertex A1 will connect to vertex B2, as the left entries of those vertices are adjacent in G, and the right entries of those vertices are adjacent in H. Those are all the connections for vertex A1. Now let's look at vertex A2. According to the first adjacency condition, vertex A2 will connect to vertex A1. As their left entries match or are the same vertex in graph G, and right entries vertex 2 and vertex 1 are adjacent in graph H. We already have this connection though, so we can move on. According to the second adjacency condition, vertex A2 will connect to vertex B2. As their right entries are the same vertex in graph H, vertex 2, and their left entries are adjacent vertices in graph G, that is, vertex A is adjacent to vertex B in graph G. According to the third adjacency condition, vertex A2 will connect to vertex B1, as their left entries are adjacent vertices in graph G, that is, vertex A and B are adjacent in graph G, and their right entries are adjacent vertices in graph H, that is, vertex 2 and 1 are adjacent in graph H. Now, going a little quicker, we can do vertex B1. The first adjacency condition tells us to connect B1 to B2, as these vertices' left entries are the same vertex in graph G, vertex B, and their right entries are adjacent vertices in graph H, vertices 1 and 2. The second adjacency condition tells us to connect B1 to A1, as their left entries are adjacent in graph G, and their right entries are the same vertex in graph H. We already have this connection though, so we can move on. The third adjacency condition tells us to connect B1 to A2 because the right entries are adjacent in graph H and the left entries are adjacent in graph G. We already have this connection too, so we can move on to vertex B2. The first adjacency condition tells us to connect B2 to B1, but we already have that. The second adjacency condition tells us to connect B2 to A2, which we also already have. And finally, the third condition tells us to connect B2 to A1, which we already have. So this is our result. Now that you know how the three adjacency conditions for a strong product work, let's find one final strong product together. What is the strong product of a cycle graph of four vertices and a path graph with two vertices? First, find the vertex set using the Cartesian product of sets. Next, determine the adjacencies according to each adjacency condition. The first adjacency condition tells us to connect vertices whose letters are the same and whose numbers represent adjacent vertices in the right graph. The second adjacency condition tells us to connect vertices whose numbers are the same and whose letters are adjacent vertices in the left graph. Finally, the third adjacency condition tells us to connect vertices whose letters are adjacent vertices in the left graph and whose numbers are adjacent vertices in the right graph. That's our result. As an interesting tidbit, the symbol for the strong product of two graphs visually represents the strong product of two path graphs of two vertices each. In fact, if you think about the previous products we covered, the tensor and Cartesian products of graphs, their symbols also represent their respective products of two path graphs with two vertices. So that's one way to remember what each symbol means. Here's a summary of strong products. To find the strong product of two graphs G and H, find the vertex set using the Cartesian product of the vertex sets of its factor graphs G and H, and then connect the vertices as if you were taking a Cartesian product of those graphs, and then keeping those connections in place, connect vertices as if you were taking a tensor product of those graphs. Every adjacency in the Cartesian product of two graphs is in the strong product of those two graphs, and every adjacency in the tensor product of two graphs is also in the strong product of those two graphs. And the vertex set of the strong product is the same as the vertex set of all other graph products, defined as the Cartesian product of the vertex sets of its factor graphs. In my next video, we're going to take a look at king's graphs, a type of graph that captures the legal moves of a king on a chessboard and is defined using a strong product. I encourage you to draw out some graphs of your own and find their strong products for practice. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, like, share, and comment. Have a great day.